My name is Helgi Steinar, stand-up comedian, independent journalist, and enthusiast of all things global. My documentaries have brought me to places like China, the British Isles, and even the radioactive ghost towns of Chernobyl. In my travels, I try to make sense of these places by talking to the locals, checking out their comedy scenes, and exploring the diverse cultures that shape the very world we live in today. On this episode of Unplugged Borders, we visit a country that has become a bit of a favorite with Icelandic comedians over the past few years.
The way we speak together when we speak this sort of Scandinavian muddle, you know, this non-language that we try to communicate, we're always leaving Finland out. Because the Finnish language is totally different. And I think, to be fair, when we meet, we should just speak Finnish. That's the way it should be done. Of course, the award ceremony would be much longer, like Mikkana Pekkana Nikkana Pekkana, you know, there's so many syllables. But the nice thing about it, too, is that Finnish just sounds so badass when you speak it. Like, if all the other Nordic countries have the same way of saying, I love you, you know, in Icelandic, jag älskar dig. In Swedish, jag älskar dig. In Danish, jag älskar dig. In Norwegian, jag älskar dig. Because the Norwegians always end everything by jumping an octave. You know, they love ski jumping and they talk like they're ski jumping. Like, oh, here comes another smith. You know, they're always... You don't even need to listen to what a Norwegian says. You just wait for him to go, whoop, and he's finished, you know? It's like, oh, det är väldigt raffligt pris festival i Reykjavik. Hyggeligt. But in Finnish, they don't say, I love you, as jag älskar dig. It's, min rakasta sinua. Which doesn't sound like anything, you know. That doesn't sound like I love you in any other country than Finland, to be honest. That sounds more like a pay the money by Wednesday, you know. We should all speak it, and the way they swear too is so beautiful. Like it's like a little symphony of swearing that's always going on. When I went to Finland, I was driving in Lapland, and there were these mosquitoes biting us. And my friends were always going like, Satana perkele vittu, Satana perkele vittu, Satana. And even the name of the mosquito was funny. Like I asked, is that mosquito? No, it's a Finnish moth. It's called a Makkarainen. Makkarainen. It's got a move to it. It sounds like Macarena. I think Macarena was invented in Finland by accident, by angry Finnish farmers who were beating mosquitoes off them. Satana perkele vittu Makkarainen. Satana perkele vittu Makkarainen. Vittu, 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 vittu Makkarainen. Makkarainen. So that's my contribution. We should switch to Finnish as soon as possible. So, my name is Ari Eldjot. Amazing to perform for you tonight. Have a wonderful evening.
Mä olen kierrellyt ympäri maailmaa, sillä kulkuri olen luonteeltain. Olen lempinyt ainakin miljoonaa, mutta rakastanut aina yhtä vain.
Ever since I was a kid, I've always wanted to visit Finland. My grandparents actually did a lot of business around Europe and said that nowhere in their travels did they find the locals to be as similar to Icelanders as they did in Finland. Now, geographically speaking, that statement doesn't really make much sense. On the Scandinavian map, Iceland and Finland really couldn't be further away from one another. But that's just it. We're not really defined as Scandinavian. We're Nordic. See, while Mommy Sweden is busy assembling furniture in front of Baby Denmark playing with its toys and trying to hide the fact that Daddy Norway is off in Thailand spending oil money, Finland and Iceland are often forgotten and left out in the cold. And we all know what happens when someone is left in isolation for too long.
Do I amaze you?
I guess in our cases, the result is heavy drinking, depression, and, well, let's say interesting music.
Katso jo tänne päin. Katoinen ystäväin. yksin kotiin itkemään jäin.
Katainen, ystäväin. And nobody actually believes it. Like when the news came out that Finland was the happiest country, there were all these sort of like street interviews and people saying, no, it cannot be true. And it's the sort of quiet contentment rather than like outwardly happiness.
Is it a result of just being drunk a lot and not talking to people?
Probably. Yeah. And I think it might be also that the younger generation does not know about the Finnish Christmas songs, which are extremely depressing.
Aika hiljainen on, tumma liikkumaton, äidin haudalle valon hän suo.
Se häkki, mi sulkee mun sirkuttajain ja vaien.
Laps hankeen hukkuu unhoittuun.
Seriously, there's one Christmas song, it's called Sparrow on a Christmas Morning. And there's a little girl and she's outside and like outside in the snow and outside this little house and she's feeding some birds with breadcrumbs, and then turns out that one of the birds is actually the spirit of her little brother who has died.
Jesus.
It's a beautiful song, but it's very sad. So, and the birds are kind of cold and being fed and bringing messages from beyond.
Yeah.
And there's another song which is about a bird that's kept in a cage and it has to sing. And its eyes have been put out because
gouged out eyes.
Yes, because then it sings, because it's the type of bird that sings in the night. So if you take out the eyes, it thinks it's dark. And
nothing like having birds having their eyes gouged out to get you into that Christmas spirit. Look, let's not mince words. Finland is a pretty badass country. I mean, we're talking about a people who choose to live in a country with winters that sometimes dip into minus 50 degrees Celsius. And still, that hasn't stopped them from being ranked the happiest nation on Earth, having one of the best education systems on the planet, and still finding time to give the world plenty of cool things like wind turbines, Nokia phones, and of course, the Finnish sauna. Sauna is actually a Finnish word, meaning bathhouse. And it is something that the Finns have actually been enjoying for thousands of years. Yep, you heard that correctly. The oldest saunas were made from pits that were dug into a slope into the ground and featured a nice little fireplace where stones could be heated by throwing water on them. While saunas may be considered a luxury in other countries, in Finland, it's simply a way of life.
So after 30 years on this planet, I have finally discovered how to get rid of a hangover. It's very simple. First, you need to go to Helsinki, you need to go to Lonna Island and get absolutely, well, not drunk, but maybe 2-3 beers will do it, right in the middle of a sauna, sweat your entire body weight out, and then jump in the ocean. So I think that's why Finns drink so much. They found the magic cure.
So let's get to know this country a little bit better. Now, the Finns call their land Suomi, or Land of Lakes, and that crazy language they speak that Ari Eltiarden was talking about at the beginning has its origins in the Finno-Ugric family, a grouping of languages that today encompasses Hungarian, Finnish, and Estonian. Finland didn't really begin being integrated into the Scandinavian family until the Vikings from Denmark and Sweden began raiding its coasts. Although it wasn't just raids, a lot of Norse people actually settled in Finland, bringing with them things like culture and customs. Now, the 12th century saw a huge power struggle over the Finnish territory between the Vikings from Sweden, the Finnish tribes such as the Tavestians and the Karelians, and of course the Russians from Novgorod. Now, after a few centuries of fighting and lots of good old Nordic inbreeding, all of Scandinavia would go on to form the Kalmar Union, uniting many kingdoms into one alliance. Now that's not to say that everything was happy endings and vodka. Finland actually had a failed peasant uprising against the Swedish Empire in 1596, and as the years went on, many Finns actually found themselves serving in the Swedish army during the religious wars of the 17th century. Finland would actually find itself getting royally fucked over during the Great Northern War in the early 1700s, resulting in the death of nearly half the population of the country. Now, during the Napoleonic Wars, Russia would go on to annex Finland while Sweden was busy fighting the French. Finland was actually given autonomy by the Russians, but it would still strive for its independence, which is something they eventually got in 1917. However, the Finns were still split on ideological grounds, and what happens when people live in a time when they don't agree and have no platform to argue with one another? Not to mention no other forms of entertainment. Yep, you guessed it, the Finns went to war with each other. Finland saw a bloody civil war that eventually ended with the defeat of the socialists. Given that Germany had aided the Finnish whites in their victory, the outcome of the war also strengthened the relationship between Finland and Germany, something that would become a little bit awkward later down the line. During the Winter War of 1939, the Soviet Union invaded Finland, and it was during this war that Finland showed just what happens when you underestimate your opponent. The Soviets invaded with tanks and planes and dinosaurs and whatnot, and all Finland had really was infantry. But Finnish troops were still trained to hunt and ski from a young age, and they knew the territory well, which gave them a clear advantage for guerrilla warfare. The Finns simply sabotaged the Soviet supply chains and picked off the Soviet troops from a distance using machine guns and incredibly skilled snipers, the most famous of which was Simo Haja, nicknamed the White Death by the Soviet troops. He is believed to have killed over 500 men during the course of the war, making him the most lethal sniper in history. Now, after World War II, Finland got sick of warfare and began to industrialize, and even played host to the 1952 Summer Olympics. By 1975, Finland had built one of the most extensive welfare states in the world, and its GDP per capita was the 15th highest in the world. Finland eventually joined the European Union in 1995, taking up the euro 4 years later, and now, ladies and gentlemen, the country is nothing but sunshine, stand-up comedy, and reindeer burgers.
Don't eat me! Okay, fuck it, go ahead and do it. Do your worst.
Tiedätte hän islantilaiset? No ne fiksut ja ihanat, joilla on niinku omas kulaa ja näin. Joo, yes. Ja nyt meillä on yksi Islannin hauskimmista miehistä täällä. Toivotetaan lavalle tervetulleeksi Helgi Steinar!
I'm born in 1989, so I never thought that I would get the chance to visit the Soviet Union. But there it was, it didn't disappoint.
Like you're saying, it looks like a town where the Soviet Union never collapsed, and everyone
relatively successful.
Relatively successful. Everyone is inspired by Kraftwerk.
But expensive alcohol.
Expensive alcohol. Yeah. I think
yesterday in this bar, Tira, after the after the show, there was this like again like some other like drunk, very drunk came in, and one of them just like heard Rammstein playing, and he just said, "Come up to us." And just goes,
like, do you hear this? This is rock
music of the future.
I do a lot, a bit of travel. We have like of course a Russian comedian tonight, Oleg. I was in Russia actually this June. It was an interesting country.
You guys went to Lada.
Yeah, well, Lada.
74. Fuck yeah.
I wouldn't be very proud of that, dude. I hope that's not your Tinder date, or this is gonna end very, very soon.
It's weird, don't you think about it? It's the happiest place in the world, right? Everyone is so happy here. You know, there's...
Even when they kill themselves, they're happy.
Yeah, because it's like, no, I decide. Like, do you think people do that while listening to heavy metal? That has to be the most metal way to die. To just, you know, off yourself while listening to heavy metal. So when the police, you know, show up and they find your body, it's like, well, at least that person had good taste.
Yeah. The policeman comes into the room and just goes, okay.
And then the paramedics show up and just a massive, you know, metal festival just around your dead body.
Which is actually the best place to have a metal festival.
And they just pour gasoline on your body, light it on fire, and just pull like satanic symbols all around. And Du hushed me.
But do you see a lot of crime going on in Lahti, or?
Yeah, there's a lot of crimes. Most of them are kind of small, but then there are the bigger ones and the more rough ones, but not so much.
Lahti used to be called like the amphetamine capital of Finland, right?
Yeah, it still is. I think it's like the third most drugs in here, and near Lahti is the top cities where there are most drugs. But Lahti is a big drug town. There's a lot of amphetamine and all sorts.
But Lahti is very inland. Like, why would Lahti be the one place where a lot of drugs come in?
History? I don't know.
I mean, like, they have to come in through Helsinki first, right?
In Lahti, there's a lot of motorcycle gangs around here, so I think that has something to do with it, but it's only speculation. I don't know the real reason why there's so much drugs. I think it's the history of the city or the area.
No, they seriously, they were like, you know, they called it the Chicago of Finland. Yeah, that's actually a good description, because after 3 days I was hoping someone would shoot me.
But yeah. do you think that the reputation is unfair about Lahti?
Nowadays, yeah. Everyone else who doesn't live in Lahti comes to me when I tell them that I'm from Lahti. They're like, "Oh, you're from the ghetto. You're like in the hardcore area." They don't know how Lahti is nowadays, because before it was a pretty rough town, but nowadays it's like every other town. There is. Every people is nice. And I haven't seen in my 24 years, like in that street picture, I haven't seen any major crimes or anything like that happening. So of course there are particular areas where there are more crimes. It's not in the middle of the city, a little bit further away, but yeah, it's not the same today than it was before.
Does that explain all the drinking? Like, people seem to be there. They really seem to enjoy their drinks here.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, I've been eating the living shit out of my liver ever since I came to Finland. Like, I thought I drank a lot in Iceland.
And I guess it's also that the sort of drinking culture is very much binge drinking.
Tack för det mig. Поехали, кемпис.
So it's not this sort of
the Danish kind of like yeah, just in the middle of the street, just kind of sipping beers and Here it's like hardcore.
Yeah, and you go somewhere to do it. Like you go into a bar or stay at home.
In your underwear.
Yes. For kalsarikanni.
For kalsarikanni.
Yes.
And then there's other things happening in Finland that I think we need to have an investigation. What is that?
Kalsarikanni.
Yes, which means getting drunk at home in your underwear.
Yeah, and we could add with no intention to go out.
Okay.
It would make sense to be sober during the summer because then it would seem to last longer, and then drink through the winter and make it go quicker that way.
All right, I'm out of time. You guys have been absolutely amazing. Thank you.
After spending a week in Finland, I realized that my grandparents were completely right about the Finns. As an Icelander, I felt right at home. Or as one of my Icelandic comedian friends so poetically put it, they're just like Icelanders, but without all the bullshit. Of all the countries I've been to, Finland was the one that really left a unique impression on me. I connected with these people in a way that I never have before, and to be honest, I can't wait to come back and make that connection again. Kiitos, Suomi.
Jos joku haluaa ottaa kuvia, ei nyt.
Ei kun nyt.
Sori. Taas mä tämmönen pitkä.